Hello guys, hope you all are fine. And today we are going to talk about fourth pharyngeal arch and sixth pharyngeal arch. Okay, so let's start it. So this is fourth pharyngeal arch. Okay, so the neuro for the fourth pharyngeal arch is vagus nerve. And which branch of the vagus nerve? That is superior laryngeal nerve. Okay, because the fourth pharyngeal arch and the sixth pharyngeal arch have same nerve. That is vagus nerve, cranial nerve number 10, okay? But which branch is for fourth pharyngeal arch? That is superior laryngeal nerve, okay? And the superior laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve is the nerve for fourth pharyngeal arch, okay? Now the muscles which is related or which is going to be derived from the fourth pharyngeal arch, that is muscle of the soft palate except tensor veli palatini, okay? So muscle of the soft palate except tensor veli palatini. Okay, for the muscles you can go and see in the later books, okay, which are the muscles of the soft palate. But remember, for the fourth pharyngeal arch, the muscle is the muscle of the soft palate except tensor veli palatini. Okay, and the muscle of the pharynx, okay, the muscle of the pharynx except stylopharyngeus muscle, because stylopharyngeus muscle is going to be derived from the third pharyngeal arch, okay. And yes, there is MCQs on this, that all muscle of the pharynx is supplied by vagus nerve except stylopharyngeus muscle, because stylopharyngeus muscle of the pharynx is going to be derived from the third pharyngeal arch, and the nerve for the third pharyngeal arch is glossopharyngeal nerve. So the stylopharyngeus muscle is going to be supplied by cranial nerve number 9, which is called glossopharyngeal nerve. So that's why, now you have to remember, muscle of the pharynx is going to be derived from the fourth pharyngeal arch except stylopharyngeus muscle, okay? So from here you know now, because the nerves for the fourth pharyngeal arch is vagus nerve, so now you know that all the muscles of the pharynx is supplied by vagus nerve except the stylopharyngeus muscle, okay? Now, cricothyroid and cricopharyngeus muscle, okay? Cricothyroid and cricopharyngeus muscle. So it means that all these muscles are going to be supplied by the vagus nerve, and that are related with the fourth pharyngeal arch. Now cartilage is laryngeal cartilage, okay? The cartilage of the larynx is going to be derived from the fourth pharyngeal arch and also from the sixth pharyngeal arch, okay? So laryngeal cartilage. Now the aortic arch, which is related with the fourth pharyngeal arch, that is fourth aortic arch, and it is going to pump the right subclavian artery, and it is going to pump arch of aorta. This is arch of aorta, this is right subclavian artery, and this is internal carotid artery, okay? Sorry, this is common carotid artery, right common carotid artery, and this is going to be right subclavian artery. So from the fourth aortic arch, is going to give us the arch of aorta and right subclavian artery, okay? So remember this, just this one is the most important points for this, for MCQs, okay? For the fourth pharyngeal arch, the muscles, and then going to be supplied by this vagus nerve, okay? Now let's talk about sixth pharyngeal arch, okay? Sixth pharyngeal arch. So the nerve for sixth pharyngeal arch is a vagus nerve, okay? As I told you guys that the nerves for the fourth pharyngeal arch and sixth pharyngeal arch is same, but the difference is the different branches. For example, for the fourth pharyngeal arch, the branch was superior laryngeal nerve. But for the sixth pharyngeal arch, the vagus nerve, which branch? Recurrent laryngeal nerve, okay? Recurrent laryngeal nerve. So now for the muscles, intrinsic muscles of the larynx except cricothyroid, okay? Intrinsic muscle of the larynx except cricothyroid, okay? Remember this point for MCQs. From here you can also know the nerve supply for these muscles, okay? So the muscle is intrinsic muscle of the larynx except cricothyroid and superior muscle of the esophagus, okay? Superior muscle of the esophagus. And cartilage, as I told you, the cartilage of the fourth and sixth pharyngeal arch is going to give us the cartilage of the larynx, okay? Cartilage of the larynx. And the sixth aortic arch, the aortic arch which is related with the sixth pharyngeal arch, that is sixth aortic arch, okay? And so it's going to form pulmonary artery, and it's going to form arch of aorta, okay? Some part of the arch of aorta and pulmonary artery. So remember this, it was easy, not difficult, okay? Hope you guys understand, okay? Study hard, enjoy your time, bye bye.